Let's talk about the most important question in historical martial arts, and that's, where do I get a sword? Or more specifically, what kind of sword do I buy? So when you're starting out, getting a new sword is usually on the top of your priorities list, and as much as it can be more useful to get a fencing mask or some decent gloves or protective gear first, most people want to buy swords first. And, you know, I'm of the mind that we're better off just rolling with that rather than telling people, oh no, don't get a sword, just get some protective gear. Nah, people want a sword because swords are awesome. But this leads to a kind of problem where you go around asking more experienced members what type of sword you should get, and most of them will tell you entirely different things. In fact, a few of my friends have said that when they went around and asked what kind of sword to get, they actually came away more confused rather than less. And yeah, this is kind of a problem. So when you're getting a new sword, the best thing to do is actually go around and not ask people what kind of sword should you get, but rather ask if you can have a play with their swords, you know, maybe fight a few bouts with their swords to get a feel for what you like. Because everyone's preference with swords are different. I prefer probably mid-length, quite fast riposte swords. Some people prefer quite long snipey swords. Some people prefer quite heavy, kind of wacky swords. Some people prefer quite short, quite quick swords. And it really comes down to personal preference. And you're better off working out what you like and what you want to play with rather than just getting a generic sword and then being stuck with that until you have enough money to get another sword. Certainly buying lots of swords until you find the one that you like is not the best way to go about it. So when you're looking to get a sword, when you have that kind of money, go and ask the people at your fencing school if you can play with their swords to work out what you want. Now obviously, when you're doing this, you need to know what kind of system you're going to do. And one of the other really important things with choosing a sword is choosing a sword that is appropriate for the sorts of systems and manuals you're fighting with. Some manuals give very specific advice about what kind of sword to get and what kind of sword they think are good. George Silver goes to great pains to describe what he thinks the optimal sword is, and to a lesser degree, Alfred Hutton says what he thinks a good sword is and actually provides a model in his manual. But even if a manual doesn't tell you what type of sword to get, you can look through and work out implicitly what kind of sword is being used. I've noticed with Telhoff, for example, the swords depicted tend to be a bit larger and longer than your typical two-handed sword available on the market. And so if you're doing a lot of Telhoffer, for example, you might want to get a longer sword or a heavier sword, because that seems to be what they're using in the manuals. And what you can do if they don't have exact measurements is you look at the size and length of the sword compared to a person's body. Now, in some artistic styles, they are going to exaggerate the size a bit, but generally the proportions are not going to be hugely off, and generally the swords are going to be much wider and broader than they are in real life, rather than being drastically longer. So have a look at how big a sword is relative to a person's body in a manual to get an idea of what kind of length and dimensions you want in your sword. Beyond that, you need to find a reputable supplier, and this is a slightly bigger challenge. There's not a huge number of reputable suppliers, as much as there are a lot of people out there making swords. A lot of swords are made for the backyard cutting market, so sharps for people who purposely want a sharp sword to chop things up in their backyard, or they're made as decorations, wall hangers, on the assumption that people are never going to use such a weapon. This makes things a bit more complicated. Personally, I've had a lot of good dealings with Darkwood Armory. They make a decent range of swords. They'll do customizations if you want. They're fairly good with their customer service. They're a bit on the pricey side, but the reality of what we do is what you get is what you pay for. So generally speaking, a more expensive sword is going to be a bit better than a less expensive one. That said, jumps in cost are much, much greater than jumps in quality, I find, at least with your lower-end suppliers. The other manufacturer I've had good experiences with is Elbian Swords. I'll include links to all the weapon suppliers I'm recommending in the description below if you want to check it out. They have a pretty good range of both fencing and cutting swords. They're mostly medieval. In fact, I think there's only a few from the classical world that aren't medieval swords, but they certainly don't have any kind of basket-hilted swords as yet, as far as I know. But if you're doing medieval martial arts, that's still pretty good. And their swords are a really good weight, they're well-balanced, and they're quite sturdy. So Elbian Swords, again, good. when you're getting to suppliers like Hanwei, it's kind of a mixed bag. Some of Hanwei's stuff is really, really good. Some of it is not so good. And that's kind of a statement on Hanwei as a whole. If you're going to get a Hanwei, and by all means, they produce some really lovely swords, make sure you order from a supplier, like a distributor that has a really good returns policy. I find with Hanweis, they will either last less than 3 months or forever. In fact, I've got most of the Hanweis that I bought when I first started out a bit over 10 years ago, and they're still in pretty good working order, give or take. So yeah, it's a bit of a mixed bag. And in the description below, I've linked to the Hanweis I've had good experiences with and I think are good. That's not an exhaustive list. There are Hanwei fencing swords that I just haven't tried. But I also make comment on some of the ones that I have tried and they're not so great, but I want to go through a list here. So when you're going to start out and you're getting your own sword, handle the swords of people in your fencing school to work out what you like. Go look at the manuals that you're working from and try and have an idea of what manuals you're going to work from as well. It can be a really good idea to sample a lot of different systems if your local fencing school or you've got a series of fencing schools you're going to offers a lot of systems, which some do. See if you've got a chance to try out as many as you can, even if it just means doing an afternoon lesson with one of the instructors in a different system over a couple of weeks, to know what kind of system you're going to want to do, work out what weapon is best for that system, work out what your preference is. I would actually give greater weight to a weapon that is your preference for fighting, even if it's a bit different to what is recommended in the system, just because I find people are different and systems have to apply to people. They're not these amorphous things that we try and perfect. And then make sure you go for a reputable and decent supplier. So Darkwood Armoury is good, Albion Swords is good. There are a number of armourers which I've listed in the description below that I've had good experiences with. And also I've listed Hanwei weapons which I think are good. But again, with someone like Hanwei, make sure they have a good returns policy just in case it breaks. Because if it doesn't break in the first 3 months, it'll probably last you until you're dead.